Audio is half of video. Now, I'm no audio engineer and I don't pretend to play one on TV, but I have taught Final Cut Pro to high school students for the past 8 years, and in that time I've learned quite a few basics about how to make your projects sound a lot better when using Final Cut Pro. The importance of audio cannot be overstated, and it really kind of seems counterintuitive at first, but people will stick with a video. They'll watch it longer if it looks bad but sounds good than they will if it looks good and sounds bad. The audio really is just that important. So here are 5 quick tips to help you get better audio with no prior audio engineering experience required. As you're jumping in to, look how my arms, they're so long on this wide angle lens. The first thing to do as you dive into your project inside Final Cut Pro is to press Shift Command 8, and that's going to bring up audio meters over on the right hand side. You can actually adjust how wide or narrow you want those audio meters to be, but I would pretty much never ever edit a project without having those meters available. Even in my classroom, when students are editing, they know that they should have those on there, and if they don't have it, sometimes as I'm walking by, I will just push Shift Command 8 and just put the audio meters up so that they're there and the students can see their audio. And as you scrub through your project on the timeline, you will see the audio meters bounce up and down, and it's really important to pay attention to those meters, even over your headphones or your speaker monitors, because there are so many variables between how you're listening to your audio versus how your audience is going to listen to your audio, that these are accurate no matter what. If the levels are good here, they're going to be good everywhere. Simple step number 2 has to deal with how you adjust your audio levels within Final Cut Pro. If you've used Final Cut Pro for any amount of time, you know the frustration that comes with trying to adjust your volume, especially accurately, using just this little slider line that appears on the timeline. Whether it's a video track with audio or a separate audio track, it's really hard sometimes to get exactly what you want. But if you go up into your inspector and you click on the speaker, there are all of your audio options, and you can either type in the level that you want your audio to be, or you can just slide this slider, which is much, much easier to get exactly the level that you want. And now that you've got your audio meters and you know how to adjust your levels, what should those levels be at? What is a good level? This is a very general, very broad rule of thumb, but as a very broad, very general rule of thumb, you want to keep your audio levels right in between negative 12 and negative 6 for like an average dialogue speaking part of your video. That doesn't mean it's not going to bounce up and down, but it just means as the meters are bouncing up and down, they're going to be right in between negative 12 and negative 6. That's not too soft, but it's not too loud. As soon as you get up towards 0, that's when you're gonna encounter peaking, which sounds like distortion and clipping, and you're not going to be able to fix that in your edit. And if your levels are too low, if they're down in like the negative 20s, it's gonna be so quiet that people can't hear it even if they turn their volume all the way up. Now, there's a whole different question when it comes to background music, and that's one of those things that is really tough. Sometimes you don't have background music, but if you're editing a short film, you might have sound effects, you might have a soundtrack. YouTube videos a lot of the time do have background music just to help make it more interesting. In general, I have found that it's good to keep your background songs somewhere between negative 35 and negative 40. That's gonna make them almost difficult to hear without headphones, but that way they're never gonna compete with your main audio. If you do want to have an audio spike, you have a loud explosion or a very surprising moment in a video and you need that loud audio, you can have it spike close to 0, but I would keep it at negative 1 max, because as soon as your audio goes to 0 or beyond, that's where you get that clipping and that peaking that just becomes impossible to fix. Tip number 3 is all about effects and presets. Just like video, Final Cut Pro has so many options that you can add to your audio to make it better. As soon as you select any clip with audio and go into the audio menu, you'll see an audio enhancements option over to the right-hand side with some equalizers. There are some presets that are actually pretty good. I've noticed that I have kind of a nasally voice, and after I've been editing videos for a long time, I want to reduce that. So I usually actually will add a bass boost to my audio, and you can see as soon as I add it, it kind of changed the waveform down at the bottom. But I've also found that with the bass boost, my voice sounds then too bassy. So rather than just leave the preset as it is, you can click this little equalizer icon and then you can adjust it to your specific liking. So I usually end up bringing down some of the low end so it's not super bassy. And then I also bring down some of the high end too, which hides that nasaliness of my natural, beautiful voice. And once you have it set the way that you want, you can actually save it as a preset in an audio category that you choose. And then you can go into your side menu anytime, go down to audio, find your preset, and then just drag it over. I completely misspelled the word super, but that's fine. I spelled it Tom's Super Beautiful Voice. And the same really goes with any effects that you add to your audio in Final Cut Pro. Just like with video, it's best to use a very light touch, use them sparingly. The presets are one thing, but if you go down to where the video effects are and you go towards the audio selection, you have tons of different things that you can add, which can be really great. But once you add them, you probably want to use a very light touch to keep them subtle. Anything that you add shows up in your audio inspector and you can adjust it, you can equalize it. It can actually almost be overwhelming how powerful Final Cut Pro can be with audio. But we don't need to worry about that right now. My main thing is just to let you know that there are presets, which can sometimes be very helpful. And sometimes they sound even better if you go in and modify them just a little bit. Nothing scientific, just to what sounds good to your ear. And last but certainly not least are audio keyframes. So just like with video, in Final Cut Pro, you can have audio keyframes. This can be something as simple as when you want audio to fade or show up. Say you have this background song and I want it to fade in. I can just drag this little circle from either end and it will fade in or out. You can also crossfade tracks into each other and around each other, get really into mixing. But if you want to go beyond that, you can add in audio keyframes. If you hold down Option and then you click on your audio track on that little line, you'll see that keyframes now start to be added in. And then you can adjust those keyframes and position them however you want. One way that I use this a lot is actually at the beginning of my videos, even though I want my background music to be at like negative 35. So rather than fade, I actually like it to start a little bit louder, not too loud where it interferes with my voice, but maybe somewhere around like, you know, negative 15, negative 17, and then slowly kind of dip down into the background. And it just sort of helps pull the viewer in, hook someone, grab their attention, but it's not super disruptive and it's not really distracting since it's not staying there throughout the whole video. You can also easily add audio keyframes by using the range tool. If you click on the tool selector or you just press R, it will give you the range option. You can just click and drag to select a portion of your audio, and then you can adjust just the audio within that portion. As soon as you go back to the select tool by clicking the arrow or pressing A, you'll notice Final Cut has then thrown in keyframes all on its own, and then you can fine-tune and adjust these keyframes and these levels as much as you want. This is great when you need to mix in different audio sources. So if I have a nice sequence of B-roll footage and music, and suddenly I want to mix in a voice, you would want your music to come down and the voice to come up, and then you might want that to change as time goes on. And when it comes to keyframes, you can add keyframes for pretty much any audio effect the same way you would for video. Anytime you're mousing over an effect and you see the little diamond with a plus sign, that means add a keyframe. If you've reached a point where you've played with a whole bunch of different effects and now you've got audio keyframes everywhere and it's hard to keep track of them, you can right click on your audio and then do show audio animation, and any keyframes you have for any settings will show up there. And my goal with this video isn't to be the definitive source on Final Cut Pro audio, it's just to help you boost your audio quality, which in turn will help improve the overall quality of your entire video. And if you are a Final Cut Pro editor like I am, I did make a video that has 5 quick tips for Final Cut Pro in general to help make your editing life a lot easier. Put that video right here so you can click on it and go check out that video.